Hi everybody, it's Crystal. Now today I'm going to show you how to make these baby booties or baby shoes. I put that on there kind of to make it look like maybe a Converse or something, but that's, you don't have to put that on there. That's just a button. So they tie up, they got laces. Just like that. So what you're going to need is, I used, this is 4-ply 100% cotton yarn. The brand is Peaches and Cream. But you don't have to use cotton. You can use acrylic. That would be fine too. Either one will work. And I used two different colors here. And then if you want a button, that's optional. I haven't even got mine sewed on yet, so you can take it off. But that's completely up to you. And I'm going to be using a size H, which is a 5mm crochet hook. Now I made mine to fit about 6 months. If you want, say, 0 to 3 month size, I would use a size needle smaller, like a 4.25, like a G. And if you want, say, 12 months, I would use one size bigger, which would be an I, a 5.5mm crochet hook. But I'm gonna do the video for using this hook, so mine's going to be the 6 month size. But again, if you're doing it bigger or smaller, just follow along with me and just change your hook size. So we're going to start with the sole of the shoe, and we're going to start with a slip knot on our hook. Okay, you want to start out with a chain of 12. Now we're going to do a half double crochet into the third stitch from the hook. And remember, we never count the one that's on our hook. So 1, 2, 3. Half double crochet into that stitch. Like that. And now I'm going to put one half double crochet in each of the next 8 stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then you'll have one stitch left, and I'm going to put 7 half double crochets all into that same last stitch. 7 of them. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now I'm going to be working my way back down this side of the chain. And I'm going to put one half double crochet in each of the next 8 stitches. So right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now I'm going to put 2 half double crochets right here in this very beginning chain where we already have half double in. I'm going to go right into it and put 2 half double crochets. Now I'm going to come over and I'm going to slip stitch in the first half double crochet. So if you look closely, here's the 2 that we just put in. This is like that little chain from the beginning where we where we did a half double crochet in the third stitch from the hook. Those are those two leftover stitches. But here's our first half double crochet, and that's the one we want to go into. Slip stitch into it. Now you should have a total of 26 stitches now at the end of this round. And if you count it and you have 26, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with a chain one. Now I'm going to work right back into that same stitch that I slip stitched into, and I'm going to put two half double crochets right into that stitch. So there's one and two. And I'm going to put two half double crochets into the next stitch. So there's one and two. Now I'm going to work my way across, and I'm going to put one half double crochet in each of the next nine stitches. So just one in each of the next nine. So there's one two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Now I'm going to put two half double crochets in each of the next five stitches. So two in each of the next five stitches, kind of around this turn here. So here's my first one. I'm going to put two stitches in it. And then two stitches in the next. Two stitches in the next. So that's three stitches so far. We put two stitches in. And two stitches in this one, which is my fourth stitch. And then two stitches in the next, which is my fifth stitch. Like that. And now I'm going to work my way across, putting half double crochet in each of these stitches down the side of this row. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. So that was nine down into this row. Now I'm going to put two half double crochets in these last two stitches, two in each of them. Two in that one. And two in that one. And if you count around, should have a total of 36 stitches now, and you want to go ahead and slip stitch into your first half double crochet. Like that. So there is the bottom part. Now we're going to kind of work building the sides up. So I'm going to start off by chaining one. Now I'm going to work my way around, putting one half double crochet in every stitch, but I'm only going to work in the back loops. So you can see that there's two loops, front loop and the back loop. I'm only going to be working in the back loop. So I'm going to go right back into the same stitch and going into the back loop only. The same stitch that I slip stitch into. It's going to be kind of tight. There we go. And half double crochet and into the back loop. And now I'm going to work my way around, putting one half double crochet in the back loop only of every stitch. And that, all that's doing is it's kind of putting that little ridge there. Just, I guess, a little bit added decoration. Like that. So I'm going to work my way around, putting one half double crochet in every stitch in the back loops only. And when I get back to the beginning, I should have a total of 36 stitches. Okay, when you make it back to the beginning, you want to go ahead and slip stitch into your first half double crochet. And I'm going to go ahead and tie off here, and you should have a total of 36 stitches. So I'm going to go ahead and clip my yarn, and I clipped it. I'm going to tie it off, and I'm going to switch colors now. Okay, I'm going to start my new color right here where we left off. Right there. And I'm going to go ahead and pull my new color through. Like that. Okay, now I'm going to start off with a chain of two. One, two. And that chain two is going to count as my first half double crochet. So that's my first one. So now I'm just going to work across, putting one half double crochet in every stitch all the way around. I'm going to be working in both loops now, not just that back loop. Just like this. So one half double crochet in every stitch across, and you should have a total of 36 half double crochet still, counting that chain two. Okay, once you make it all the way around and you have a total, your 36 stitches, you want to go ahead and slip stitch into the top of this beginning chain two. Just like that. Okay, now I'm going to start off again with the chain of two. One, two. And that's going to count as my first half double crochet. Now I want to put one half double crochet in the next 10 stitches, this being my first one. So there's one, and you want to make sure you get this little stitch right here, because that's our next half double. Sometimes when you do a chain two and you slip stitch into it, you kind of can't see that one, but that one is one. So we want to do 10 in a row, so count that chain two. There's two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. So counting that chain two, we have 10 half double crochets in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I want to put a half double crochet two together over the next two stitches. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to yarn over and go into the next stitch, and I'm going to draw up a loop, and I'm going to yarn over again and go into the next one and draw up a loop. And I have five loops on my hook. I'm going to yarn over and go through all five. So what that did is it made two stitches into one. Now I'm going to do that again. So I'm going to yarn over and go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, five loops on my hook, yarn over and go through all five. So that is a half double crochet two together. Now I'm going to be doing double crochet two togethers, and I'm going to do it 5 times. So a double crochet two together is yarn over, go into the next stitch, and drop a loop. Now I'm going to yarn over and go through the first 2 loops on my hook. Now I'm going to yarn over again and go into the next stitch and drop a loop. I'm going to yarn over and go through the first 2 loops on my hook. And then I'm going to go yarn over and go through the remaining 3 loops on my hook. That is a double crochet two together. And I want to have 5 of them total. So that was my first one. So now I'm going to move to the next spot. I'm going to yarn over, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first 2 loops. Yarn over again and go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first 2 loops, yarn over and go through all 3. So that was, now we have 2 double crochet two togethers. Again, yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first 2. Yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first 2, and yarn over and go through all 3. So now we have 3 double crochet two togethers, and I'm going to do that 2 more times. So that's 4 double crochet two togethers. And that's 5 double crochet two togethers. Now we're going to do 2 half double crochets together like we did on the other side. So I'm going to yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through all 5 loops. So that's 1 half double crochet two together. And I'm going to do that again. Like that. And now I'm going to work 1 half double crochet in the remaining 8 stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and then I'm going to slip stitch into the top of my beginning chain 2. And I think I pulled it kind of tight, so just like that. So that's what we have so far. Now I'm going to start off with a chain 2 again. Counts as my first half double crochet, and I'm going to do 10 half double crochets, 1 half double crochet over the next 10 stitches. This chain 2 counts as my first one. So I'm going to yarn over, and remember our next one's right here. Sometimes it gets lost, but we need to make sure that we get that one. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay. Now I'm going to do a half double crochet two together. So I'm going to yarn over, go into the next stitch, and drop a loop. Yarn over, go into the next one, drop a loop, yarn over and go through all 5. So that was a half double crochet two together. Now I'm going to do a double crochet two together over the next, or we need to do that over, we need to have 3 of them. So I'm going to yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first 2, yarn over and go in the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first 2, and all three. So that's a double crochet, two together. I'm going to do that again. So that's two double crochet twos together. I'm going to do that one more time. So there's three double crochet, two togethers. Now I'm going to do a half double crochet, two together. Just like that. And now I'm going to put one half double crochet in each of the remaining seven stitches. So there's one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Now I'm going to go ahead and slip stitch into the top of my beginning chain two, and now I'm going to tie this off right here at this spot. So I'm going to clip my yarn and tie that off. Okay, now I'm going to go back to my beginning chain two, and counting that chain two, I'm going to go over this way. Here's the toe. Seven stitches. So counting that one, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And that's where I'm going to start my next. That's where I'm going to start. So right there. And I'm actually going to start again with the slip knot on my hook with the same color I'm still using. So if you want to, if you look, here is the half double crochet two together from the last row. You go over one, two spots from that one, or seven spots counting this chain two. And go ahead and start out. Now I'm going to start out with a chain one. And I'm going to go right back into that same spot and do a half double crochet into that same spot. Just like that. So counting that first, this first half double crochet here, I want to have a total of 17 across. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you want to make sure you're getting this one right here by that chain too, because sometimes he don't look like a stitch, but he is. So that's my yarn split. That's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. And if you look here, you should have 5 unworked stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So now I'm going to chain one and turn. And I'm going to go right back in that same stitch and half double crochet. And I'm going to work one half double crochet in every stitch across until I get back around to the other side. should be 17 again. And when you make it to this side again, I'm going to chain one and turn, and I'm going to go across one more time, half double in that very first stitch, putting one half double in every stitch. Back to the other side, and again you should have 17 one more time. And when you make it around, you want to go ahead and tie this off. Make sure you got 17 on that last row too. I'm going to clip that off. Tie that. I'm going to clip some of these tails on the inside. I tried to hide them while I went, so. So I didn't have so much to hide later. Okay, now I'm going to open it up and I'm going to work on the tongue of the shoe. So again, I'm going to start with a slip knot on my hook of the same color, or you can use whatever colors you want, but I'm going to use the same. And I'm going to start in the first unworked stitch. So you can see this one has a half double in it, so we'll go to this next one. And I'm going to pull through like that. And I'm going to start with a chain one. Now I'm going to go right back in that same stitch and half double crochet. And I'm going to put one half double crochet across in each of these five unworked stitches. So that was my first one. There's two, three, four, and five. Now I'm going to chain one and turn, half double right back in that same stitch, and I'm going to go across the end. One, two, putting half doubles, three, four, five. Again, chain one and turn, go across the end, starting in that very first stitch. One, two, three, four, five. Again, chain one and turn. One, two, three, four, oops, five. So that was a total of one, two, three, four rows of half double crochet there on that for the tongue. And then I'm going to go ahead and tie this off, clip that yarn. Okay, you can go ahead and hide that tail and everything if you want. And now I got, starting with the slip knot on my hook one more time, I'm going to start right here in this stitch that the half double from the tongue is going into. So here's that half double from the tongue. I'm going to start right in the same stitch as that. And I'm going to go ahead and pull the yarn through and chain one. Kind of tight here. Okay. Now I'm going to work one single crochet in every stitch up across the side. And starting in the next stitch, not that same stitch that we started into, but the next one. And it's going to be kind of hard to see where they go. So just kind of evenly space out the single crochets across the top here. Just do the best that you can. And when I make it, when you make it to the top up here, I'm going to put two single crochets into that top corner stitch. And then I'm going to continue working across the top, putting one single crochet in every stitch across the top. And you can see, you know, the stitches weren't really, you couldn't really see, so I just kind of evenly spaced out the single crochets here. And now I'm working across the top of the shoe, putting one single crochet in every stitch. Now when I get to the corner stitch here, I'm going to put two single crochets in the corner stitch. And now I'm going to work my way back down this side, kind of just evenly spacing out my single crochets down the side. Just doing the best that you can. I know it's kind of hard to tell where they need to go, but and then when you make it down here to the stitch on this side of the tongue, that the tongue, or that the first half double crochet is in of the tongue, see it right here, just go ahead and slip stitch into that stitch. And that will, and you can tie that off and that'll finish that out. Now you can go ahead and hide any tails that you have left. Okay, once you get all your tails hidden, now I'm going to put a lace on it. What I do is I cut a long piece of string, a long piece of yarn, and I'm going to use my yarn needle, and I'm going to lace it just like shoes, just like you'd lace shoes. So I'm just going to kind of start over here, right on the other side of the tongue. I'm just going to kind of go through a stitch. Pull it through. Leave it kind of long though, so you can tie it at the top like that, or you can pull this one and lace it through too. So then I'm going to come over to the other side of the tongue and pull it through. I'm just kind of going through, not really going like sewing it, I'm just going through the stitch. Now I'm going to go across the top over here to the other side, kind of skip a couple stitches and go right through the stitch. See, I'm just going through the stitch. Now I'm going to do the same over here. Skip a couple, maybe go up to the top. And then I'm going to take that out, and I'm going to grab my other string and do the same. Just lacing it like you lace the shoe, you know, with shoelaces. Come over here, pick one of these stitches up, go through. And then back over here towards the top. And go through. And you can do cross them as many times as you want, but something like that, you know, just kind of like laces. Probably lace it any way you wanted, but. And then you just want to straighten out your laces a bit. Make sure they're all kind of even. And then you'll be able to tie it. And you can clip your yarn then after you get it tied just to the length that you want. Like, I'll probably clip some of these here off so they're not quite so much hanging. But that's it. And then if you want to add a button or something on the side, or you can, you don't have to, or make a little swoosh or something for the Nike symbol, but whatever you want to do, that's all there is to it. So I hope you enjoy my tutorial. You just make two the same, exactly the same. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to come check me out on Facebook too, where you can post pictures of all your crochet items on there. I'd really like to see it. And until next time, have a good day.